Space Marine scouts are specialists in operating behind enemy territory, sowing disruption and eliminating key targets with their deadly sniper rifles. In this video, we're going to show you exactly how to paint a sniper scout of the Noble Ultramarines chapter up to battle-ready standard using the contrast painting method. Now, to prepare our model for painting, we've already undercoated it with Grey Sear. We've actually used a spray here to make life a bit quicker and easier, but you can use the paint out of a pot if you'd like to. Once the undercoat is dry, it's time to move on to the contrast painting stage. And the first paint we're going to use, naturally, is Ultramarines Blue for his armour. So grab your medium shade brush and let's get started. So we're going to take a little bit of paint out of the pot like so and just apply it to our palette like this. We're just making sure we're not overloading the brush with too much paint. There we go, perfect. Then, onto our miniature, we're going to apply Ultramarines Blue all over the blue areas of our scout's armour. Now, it might be confusing as to exactly which parts of the armour are meant to be blue, so have a good look at either the Games Workshop website or the box art to make sure. As you're applying your contrast paints, you want to apply them quite thickly, but make sure as they're drying, they're not gathering in areas or pooling, so make sure you're moving the paint around with your brush to avoid this. Allow about 5 minutes for it to fully dry, and then we'll move on to the next stage. And there we go, the Ultramarines Blue contrast paint has dried. You can see it's given this really cool effect on the armour. You can also see that we've been a bit messy and gone over the areas which shouldn't be blue with a bit of the contrast paint there. So the next thing we're going to do is actually go back with the Grey Sear base coat paint and tidy up those areas again, ready for the next contrast paints. So grab yourself a medium layer brush. It's going to take a little bit of the Grey Sear out of the pot like so. Onto our palette here, it's going to water it down just a touch with a touch of water from our pot there. And then onto our miniature, we're just going to touch up the miniature. Any area that shouldn't be blue that's had blue contrast paint hit it, we're just going to go back over now. You might need a couple of coats of this to get a nice solid base coat, but it's really worth doing to make the model nice and neat. So there we go, we've tidied up with the Grey Sear base coat paint, and we're ready now to move on to the next contrast paints. I'm going to do a few more of the details next. We're going to start off with Skeleton Horde, which is going to go onto the model's cloth. Then we're going to be using Griffcharger Grey on the cloak on the back, then Basilicanum Grey on the rock on the base, all the metal areas and the gun, and finally Black Templar, which we're going to be using on the boots, the leather and the gun casing. So grab yourself your medium layer brush here, just for a bit more control. We're going to take a little bit of our Skeleton Horde here. Again, just taking a little bit out of the pot and putting it onto the palette like so. Just make sure we're not overloading that brush. Then, onto the miniature, we're applying Skeleton Horde onto the cloth. So that's the trousers he's wearing, and also the shirt he's wearing on the top as well. Next up, we're applying Griffcharger Grey to the Scout's cloak. We're using a medium shade brush here to make it nice and quick, but make sure we're avoiding pooling, so any areas where the paint might gather in the recesses, make sure you're just picking that up with a brush. Once this first layer is dried, we're actually going to apply a second coat to give a really nice solid colour. Next up, we're painting Basilicanum Grey onto the entire sniper rifle and any other areas of the model that might be metal, so for example the goggles around his head. We're also going to paint it onto the rock he's standing on the base as well. Next up, we're painting Black Templar onto our model's boots, leather, the hair and also the casing of the sniper rifle. And there we go, with the Black Templar blocked in, that's the major details of our Space Marine Sniper Scout filled in. So now it's time to move on to the next few details on the miniature. We're going to start off with Gilliman Flesh, which we're going to paint all over our scout's face. Then we're going to paint Nastra Gile to pick out the gold details. Then we'll use Dark Angel's Green to pick out some of the lenses and one of the wires. And then Blood Angel's Red to pick out the other lenses and the other wire as well. So let's move on to the Gilliman Flesh. And again, for this, we're using our medium layer brush. I'm going to take a little bit of paint out of the pot like so. Now for this, we're making sure that there's not much paint on the brush at all, as it's quite a small detail, so we need to make sure the paintbrush is quite thin. There we go, perfect. Then onto our miniature, we're just going to very, very carefully paint Gilliman Flesh onto our scout's face. Next up, we're painting Nazdra Yellow onto the golden details of our miniature. So check out the skull motifs on his armour and his gun here as well. And if you can see the Aquila or the Chest Eagle, pick that out too. Up next, we're painting Dark Angel's Green onto the top of the wires coming out of the gun and also onto the lenses of the goggles. And the last contrast paint we're applying is Blood Angel's Red, which we're placing onto the other wire coming out of the gun and also the lenses on the scope on the sniper rifle. And there we go, with all the contrast paint applied and dried, our Space Marine Sniper Scout is almost ready for the battlefield. There's only one thing left to do, of course, and that's to apply a textured base to our miniature. And for ours, we're going to be using a Grelin Earth to make our base look all cracked and dry. You can, of course, use whichever of the texture paints you like for your miniature. Now, for this, we're going to be applying it with a medium base brush. I'm just going to get a little bit out of the pot like so. We want quite a thick dollop. Perfect. Then, onto our miniature, we're just going to apply it evenly over the top of the base. Now, with a Grelin Earth, we want to make sure it's a nice thick coat on top. The thicker it is, the bigger the cracks will be. But at the same time, make sure you're being very careful not to hit the model's feet or the rock. Now, spread it around evenly all over the base. Allow about 2 hours for it to fully dry, and once it has, we're going to be applying Steel Legion Drab to the rim of the base. And there we go, with the Grelin Earth dry and the base rim painted Steel Legion Drab, our Space Marine Sniper Scout is ready for action behind enemy lines. And that's how you paint Space Marine Sniper Scouts of the Ultramarines chapter up to Battle Ready standard using the contrast method. Couple of things to remember here. First of all, when you're applying your contrast paints, try and be as neat as you possibly can, but don't worry if you make a mistake. As you saw at the start, you can always go back over areas you need to with the original base paint. Second of all, when you're painting larger areas such as the cloak or the armour, try to make sure you're moving the paint around to avoid it grouping and pooling. Hope you found the video useful. Happy painting!